Today we'll study the poem Animals by Walt Whitman. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? We'll find in this poem how beautifully the poet explains that why he wants to leave the human beings and go and live with animals. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. They are so calm and self-sufficient. They don't need anything from the world. I stand and look at them long and long. He admires them, stands there and looks at them and finds that they do not sweat and whine. They don't crib about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not even one is dissatisfied. Not one is demented with the mania of owning things. So he says that they're so calm, contented, that he wants to learn something from the animals. He desires to live among the animals because he feels that animals are calm and self-sufficient. They do not grumble about their condition. They do not commit any sins, so they do not weep at night. While human beings lie awake at night, they cry for the wrong that they have done, whereas animals are satisfied with what they have and do not desire to possess materialistic things. They do not whine and weep about their condition. They don't idle away their time in discussing their duties towards God. They are not crazy and obsessive about things, about hoarding and owning materialistic things. So the poet finds animals to be calm, satisfied, peaceful. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. So he feels that they don't have to bend, bow to others. They all are equal. They believe in equality. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So everyone is so happy. All the animals are happy. They're equally respected. So they're equally loved and nobody is superior or inferior. So they show their relation to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. Now here the word tokens refers to the virtues. Human beings have always been kind, honest, sincere, calm, self-contained and contented with whatever they have. So he says, they bring me tokens of myself. Once human beings were like this, but now it is the animals who have all the virtues. I wonder where they get these tokens. I wonder where they get those tokens. Means from where have they picked up all those virtues which once belonged to human beings? Did I pass that huge times ago and negligently drop them? I just dropped them, gave up my good qualities, and those people have. Those animals have picked them up. The animals believe in equality and no one is superior or inferior. They all are happy. They do not kneel in front of anyone. Your thousands old descendants are also not regarded as superior to anyone. The animals show their relation to the poet, and he accepts them happily and wants to live with them. Their kindness and honesty reminds him of the virtues which humans once possessed. The virtues have been dropped due to negligence, and the animals have imbibed them. The poem Animals has been written in free verse. It means that there is no rhyme scheme of the poem. The poet tells us that he feels more at home with animals than humans. The poet appreciates some qualities in animals which humans do not have. He finds the animals to be simple and true, whereas he thinks humans are complicated and false. And as you have read the poem, the meanings are very clear. Kneel to bend down, to reveal. Tokens here, the word has been used as quality. Demented is crazy, disturbed. So we can just conclude the poet is fascinated by the animals and finds them to be better than humans. He says the animals are so calm and self-sufficient. They do not depend on others. They do not crib or fret about their condition like the human beings do. They lead a peaceful life and sleep soundly. They do not weep for their sins because they do not commit any sins. They do not sermonize. They are satisfied and do not yearn for things. They are not materialistic and do not have a craze of collecting things. They believe in equality, hence no one bows before another. They are all equal and no one is superior. No one is looked up to or looked down for them. All are equal. The poet is surprised to see how the animals now have all the good qualities that once human beings possessed. He calls these qualities as tokens. These tokens are tokens of kindness, equality, peace and contentment. The poet feels that humans are now devoid of any good qualities. He questions himself if he had negligently dropped all the tokens of humanity. Thank you. Have a nice day.